You have a certain term, I guess. I don't know who coined the phrase, but it's called time-restricted feeding.
Yeah.
And you've done, there's been experiments that you've done in mice where you've fed them various types of food, high-fat diet, high-sugar diet, or normal chow diet, and you've restricted their time feeding, you know, during their, the nights, you know, the mouse day hours, which is actually the night because night they're time. Nocturnal.
Yeah.
And you found, you know, some very interesting things. So can you talk a little bit about those findings?
So what we have seen is when we, in experimental animals, if they don't have a clock, then their metabolism goes really weird. So just like I said, a metabolism works like this traffic signal in downtown, and if they're not timed properly, then there'll be disease. Similarly, for a very long time, we knew in the field that mice that don't have circadian clock, because they lack a gene or have a mutation, they have various metabolic defects. They have obesity, diabetes, cardiovascular disease, etc. We also know people who do shift work for a very long period of time, they are also highly likely to get metabolic disease, cancer, accelerated aging. So there was this idea that clocks are important. If we don't have a good functioning clock, then that's bad for us. Then we went back and asked, okay, in normal circumstances, what are the conditions that can actually break down our clock? And what we found was, when mice are given high-fat diet or any unhealthy food, then the food itself breaks down their clock. So they actually don't have a good eating, fasting rhythm. So the mice eat throughout day and night. And we knew that high-fat diet and high-fructose diet, high-sucrose diet, all of these diets that are used experimentally in laboratory conditions give rise to all this disease. And people always thought it's what and how much the mice ate that determined the disease. But what we found is, well, these mice are also not eating at the same time. So maybe when they eat also matters. So we did a very simple experiment where we took two groups of mice, completely identical set of mice. No genes were changed, no drugs were given. And one group of mice ate whenever they wanted to eat. And we, to begin with, we gave them a high-fat diet. So they're getting somewhere between 45% to 60% of their food from fat, calories from fat. So that means it will be equivalent to humans eating all of their food from cheese, nachos, ice cream, or Western diet.
So they're getting fat and sugar.
So they're getting fat and sugar, all this stuff. And then the other group got the same number of calories and the same type of food, exactly identical food. But they had to eat all their food within 8 to 12 hours in nighttime. So in some experiments, we have done 8 hours, 9 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours, like that. And the most surprising thing is, means this is something that everybody, lot of laboratories around the world do. There are 11,000 papers showing high-fat diet causes obesity. And we said, okay, so now we control for time. So since time was restricted, calorie was not restricted. So that's why you call it time-restricted feeding. And surprisingly, the mice that ate for 8 to 12 hours, they did not become obese, diabetic, and they had a normal liver function, and they had normal cholesterol, etc. And then in the next set of experiments, we exposed these mice to high fructose diet, high carb diet, high sucrose diet, all kinds of diets, either ad libitum whenever they can eat, or they have to eat within 8 to 12 hours. And in most cases, we see the time-restricted feeding has huge beneficial impact. Even when mice eat standard diet, normal chow, which is supposed to be very healthy, and mice actually eat most of their food, nearly 70% of food during nighttime. They eat a little bit during daytime. But if they completely restrict that to 8 to 12 hours, then their muscle mass goes up, their fat mass decreases, and they're more coordinated. So if you put them on a rotating drum, then they coordinate on the rotating drum for a long time. So the bottom line is this time. So in this in these experiments where we kept what and how much they ate constant, the only thing that we changed is when they ate, then we see this huge beneficial impact. And that correlates with very robust clock in the liver and in other metabolic organs. And why this is important is two things. One is many of us have really bad lifestyle. I won't say bad, but we don't have much control over what and how much food we eat. As soon as we get out of our home, all the food we eat outside, we have very little control over it. So the only control we have actually is on our time. So that's why we think this can be a good entry point to a better living by controlling time. And then the second thing is, it also doesn't take away this idea that nutrition doesn't matter, the quality doesn't matter, because even in our high-fat fed mice, we don't see they completely become normal, just like the normal chow-fed mice. They're much healthier. So to have better health, you still have to change what and how much you eat, but timing becomes much easier to manage.
So these, you just covered like so much. This experiment that you did right here, this publication, even before, you know, you've gone on to some small human studies, but this convinced me to do a time restricted feeding schedule because, well, for a couple of reasons. But so just like to reiterate, these mice that were fed a high fat diet, they fed the same amount of calories, but of those that ate during their waking hours, night within, I think it was 12 hours, they had 70% less fat mass.
Yeah, so they had 28% less body mass total.
Right.
And that change in body mass is mostly due to fat because they had 70% less fat.
That's amazing.
Yeah, that's really...
right there. And they're eating the same crappy food, but they're eating it when their liver can process it the best, when they're able to regulate their blood sugar, when they're able to oxidize fats, things like that.